Commissioner Love?
I would like to add to what has just been said, but concerning the capital appropriation process in Colorado. We've been terribly successful, in my view, over the last several years in getting what we request. Colorado has always faced some problems, but they get overshadowed by those that we encounter in New Mexico. I just want to make sure that all of you understand the 1.295, which has become sort of the gold standard in Colorado, is not a certain thing. And we are in the final year of the continuing resolution that has been attached to our appropriation. And continuing resolution just simply expresses the view of the current legislature that next year's legislature honor what it is that we're requesting. It's not a fixed thing. This year's battle was over how much money the state of Colorado could retain under the so-called Tabor laws. Through some maneuvering that I don't know the voters would really approve, but nonetheless, the legislature came up with a way of solving the cap on the revenues that the state had, and we were therefore saved again. Well, the process is that the governor submits a budget, the legislature then looks at that budget, does its own thing, then does its individual house analysis, and then approves or disapproves the final budget, and that's the shorthand version. We are currently in the governor's budget process right now. It is being developed. And as far as I know, we are in good shape, and the governor will include it. I will hasten to add that the governor is term limited and will no longer be our governor as of January 19. So we have one session in effect where we don't have a lame duck situation, and there are enough candidates to probably fill all of the government seats in Colorado for the governor's job itself. So it's going to be an interesting race, and that's an uncertainty we have to deal with. So my only message is that while we've been terrifically successful, for which I'm terribly thankful, we have some headwinds that we have to deal with going forward.
So it's not an annuity?
It certainly isn't.
Understand.
Too bad. All right, thank you. We'll have an update from the Friends. Oh, yes, George, please.
Commissioner Cowles, weren't you going to touch bases on the audit cycle?
Thank you for reminding me. This is the last year for the under our policies and practices for the current auditing firm in Colorado, and next year it shifts to a New Mexico auditor, and so we'll be issuing an RFP according to the standards used by New Mexico state auditor, and that will probably come out in time for the next commission meeting in October. So we have to start looking around and introducing, finding ourselves, there'll be a learning curve again for auditors in dealing with our special requirements. Just stay tuned, and we'll have more news at the October meeting. If you have any auditing firms that in New Mexico that you think ought to apply, let me know. Thank you.
Anything else on finance? Great. Thank you. Next, we'll have the Friends of the CTSRR report given by Ed Baudette.